In this tutorial, you will need to add ease to each measurement. Ease is very important when you take into consideration the movement and folds of your body, especially when wearing garments with little to no stretch. These pants aren't meant to fit snug in this tutorial. I just want to let you know that I do have a link in the description bar below that shows a much easier way to create this pants pattern by using a pair of pants in your very own closet. So I will go ahead and let you finish watching this pictorial of how to draft your pants pattern. And you can also read the instructions to the right. All right. Ruffle guidelines will be created by first measuring your waist to crotch length, dividing the number in half, and using the calculation as your desired width between each guideline. The last guideline on the bottom of the pants should measure the full length or more of the waist to crotch measurement. The length of your actual ruffle will be the length of your waist to crotch measurement. Now, let's look at an illustration. There will be three different radius measurements you will need for your ruffles. You will have your waistline measurement, the line in between your waist and your crotch, and then of course your crotch measurement. You will have one of each, excluding your crotch line. The length of your pants will determine how many ruffles you have for your crotch line.
To find our calculations for the waist radius of our skirt, so I went to google.com and I put in circle skirt calculator, and I went to byhandlondon.com, which is the first option you'll see in the search results, and it gives you the step-by-step instructions on what you need to do to figure out your radius. Now I kept it in inches. I did a full circle skirt and I put in my waist measurement in the waist measurement option. And I ignored the length because I'm doing a peplum style. So right now I just wanted to make sure I got the waist radius. So my waist radius was... Thank you.
let me talk you through this step here. Now, when you're closing up your ruffles on each pant leg, you want the hem of your ruffle to be facing upward towards your waist. And then you want to pin both of the open seams together. And you want to make sure that the seams are facing inside of the ruffle. So the easiest way to do that is being sure that the hem of your ruffle is actually facing upward towards your waist versus how it would normally lay when you put your pants on, which is downward towards your hem.